Hey guys, what's up? Eric Merced here, and in this video, I want to do something different. I want to talk about the importance of using flats in your artwork, whether it's for comic book coloring or for illustration of any kind. I just want to touch upon the importance of using flats as your groundwork for coloring your art in any app, whether it be Photoshop, Procreate, Clip Studio Paint. There's a reason why artists use flats when they color their work, and I just want to touch upon that. If you haven't yet, there is a video where I explain how to flat in Clip Studio Paint and in Procreate. I'm going to leave the links to those videos in the description so you can check them out if you really don't know what flatting is. But I really don't want to go into what flatting is in this video. I just want to talk about the reasons why I and a lot of artists like to use flatting in our work when we're coloring. So one of the questions could be, well, why not just go in and color without using flats as a base? And I'm going to show you my flats for this image I did of the Joker and Harley Quinn. So if we take away all the inks and all the shadows and stuff like that, you can pretty much see how these base colors are laid in there. There are some open spots which I can go and fill in, but I feel that that's not necessary to fill those open spots where the line work shows. But basically, this is what flatting is. It's just laying down these flat base colors and then on other layers building up with shadows and highlights and effects and all that kind of stuff. Every time I color, whether it be in Procreate or Clip Studio Paint, I go ahead and I do flats because, and I'm going to explain the reason why it's so important and it's such a good idea to use flats in your work. So I have an image here that I created. It's just an image of simple shapes, but I created this image so that I can pretty much show why I use flats in my coloring. And why it helps out to use flats, why it's so important to use them to help simplify the coloring process. So right now I have two layers. The first layer is the inks layer, and the second layer is the flats layer. So normally the process is usually the same. After my work is inked, I will go ahead and lay out my flats on a separate layer, and I'll keep that layer separate from the inks layer. Now, if I wanted to color in this middle sphere, for example, I can just go ahead and create a new layer and set it to multiply and choose my color, which will be a dark purple, and choose a brush, like for example, I'm going to go ahead and choose an airbrush. And on that multiplied layer, I can go ahead and color in, let's change that a little bit, a nice little shadow on that sphere. All right, so now I have a problem, and the problem is that I've colored out here on the outside. So how do I fix this? Well, the easy way is using my flats layer. So one of the things I'm going to do is go ahead and set my flats to reference. Now I'm going to go ahead and choose the selection tool and set it to automatic and choose that middle sphere and choose invert, go back to the layer where I did my shadows, and tap on clear, and automatically in a couple of steps, I got rid of all of the colors outside of the sphere that I didn't want. I can also go in and choose these other sections of the spheres that were colored in, and now choose clear, and I can get rid of the colors in the other spheres, so I can color each one of these sections individually. So that's one of the reasons why you want to use flats. It really simplifies the coloring process by allowing you to choose sections of your drawing so that you can make edits. Now, another thing that I can do is say, I don't like the color of this flat right here in the middle sphere. I want to do more of a, let's do a purple color. So one of the things that I can do is go ahead and choose that color individually and then choose the adjustments menu, hue and saturation, and adjust the color until I can get a more purplish color. And I can go ahead and choose the adjust the saturation or the brightness of that purple color. Like that. And just as easily, I can choose again that same color which I'm editing in my flats layer and go up to the layer where I have my inks, where I have my shadows, and I can do the same thing and do an adjustment of the hue, saturation, and brightness so that I can bring those shadows out so they can show a little bit more. So you can see how using flats really helps simplify the process of coloring and editing. When you're done with your drawing, the editor tells you, yeah, that shirt on that character looks nice, but change it to a different color. You can easily do that if you have flats, and I'm going to show you that with that Joker and Harlequin drawing that I did. So let's say in this drawing I want to change the Joker's shirt to a different color because his hair is green, his shirt is green, and I just want to mix it up a little bit and change it. I'm going to go to my flats layer, zoom in here a little bit, and choose my selection and make sure it's set to automatic. And automatically I can choose just that shirt, and I can go in into hue and saturation, and I can play around with changing the color. So having my flats layer allows me to go in and change pretty much almost any color in the image. As long as the colors are separated, I can go in and change any color. I can change the color of the rose. I can change Harley Quinn's colors. I can change the Joker's hair color. I can change any element that's colored in this image because I've gone ahead and I've separated each element into its own flats. So that's one of the reasons why you want to get into the habit of using flats in your images when you're coloring, instead of just going ahead and coloring everything in one layer and adding the shadows and the highlights in that same layer. It's nice to keep things separated, and it's nice to use flats in coloring. Hope this video has helped explain why I choose and a lot of artists choose to use flats. If you have any other ideas, you can leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and God bless, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.